into the straitjacket aspect of time, and it's more almost really happening around.
All right, so we started with the Rothko here.
The truth about this period of time.
Teal, blue, a little green, a little white.
It would be nonsense.
I do have my Rothko picture that I'm working from. Got cool. See the contrast of that deep water, black line, like the horizon. A little wisp of sunrise or something. Has the feeling of horizontal, but you do have vertical, almost like horizon. Very, very cool. So, I think I want to go back in with this and add a little bit of blue.
Fresh air is next.
And this is some of my leftover paint from earlier. Now, dry brush, right? You can work it in, and as it's drying, it's like in the washes, you can kind of push that in. Does it have to be perfect? No. It's nice to have a reference that doesn't turn off.
Support for NPR comes from this station.
I kind of want to see if I can get some contrasts.
American Experience tells the story of the man who created the Fujita scale.
Just some of those details
there.
See that? Darker definition. Just the hint. See, just a taste. Now he would take oils with turpentine, but we can do the same thing. Okay, color field abstraction. And we'll flip this around. Leave this here. These are my dogs. And in relation to this, now we get a chance to get creative. I grabbed a clean brush. That I'll clean. What do we got here? Reds. This is leftover red from a drip. I'm actually looking at it upside down, so I'll go like that. Watch. See how it's almost dry.
In the past, Renee offered clues about her life while performing as her alter ego, the android Cindy Mayweather. But now she's speaking more openly as a black queer artist.
I didn't pre-mix
things that shaped her life and art,
any.
Growing up in Kansas's poorest county and how wearing tuxedos, as she often does, is a statement about her family as well as gender fluidity. First News.
Live from NPR News, I'm Jack Spear. Attorney General William Barr today said he does not expect an investigation into the origins of the FBI's Russia investigation, and with criminal probes by either former President Barack Obama or presidential hopeful Joe Biden. Attorney General's remarks come even as Trump has stated without evidence he believes Obama committed unspecific crimes as president. Today, Trump said he had the situation been first, he thinks things would have been very different.
Well, I think it was me they would do it. I think people would then maybe they're not going to. I'm surprised because Obama knew everything that was happening. I don't think Obama knows where he is in a lot of ways. I saw his statements the other day, and I think that, frankly, they weren't very good. It's President Obama.
Speaking at an unrelated news conference today, Barr said the Justice Department will not be swayed by political pressure to investigate the president's opponents.
See how it's dry?
Used for partisan political ends.
Barely.
The Justice Department lashed out at Apple again today with a long-standing fight over access to
blockchain. And as you realize, you're going to be able to go in there and work that yellow and make orange. Okay, put that off to the side. I'm not even going to rinse it.
Federal authorities spent months trying to crack into two
items that belong
to the gunman in the Pensacola attack. Only problem...
Yellow's not as strong.
Apple refused to help. The company's stance is that a so-called backdoor for authorities is a risky move that could jeopardize security for millions of Apple users. Now, FBI Director Christopher Wray says investigators have uncovered a trove of evidence after finding their own way into the phones without Apple.
So we did it ourselves. Unfortunately, the technique that we developed is not a fix for our broader Apple problem.
Ray said the bigger policy bite continues. Hannah Lamb, NPR News.
Quick and fast and mean. Does it have to look exactly? No. Rothko is a different cat.
Interim appointment comes after North Carolina Republican Senator Richard Burr voluntarily relinquished the chairmanship while he faces an FBI investigation. Burr's under scrutiny.
Yellow is not as strong.
During the early days of the pandemic, whether he violated any laws.
That is really strong.
Last week after the FBI seized his cell phone as part of that.
It alludes to a landscape.
Is already a senior member of the Senate Intelligence Committee.
Now remember, Rothko was right up there with Jackson Pollock. Same time period, same music. Rothko is a crazy Russian.
Stocks roared back today. The S&P was up more than 3%. That was on reports of some progress being made toward coming up with a coronavirus vaccine. The Dow was up 111 points. This is
Immigrant Rothkolowski, something like that, changed it to Rothko.
They announced the restart of healthcare services in Washington. Elective procedures can resume and dentist offices can reopen.
From our previous work, we have done color blending.
Must meet certain criteria to be able to begin performing elective procedures again.
Now, are we trying to make it look real in any sense?
Without overwhelming the healthcare system. Officials in King County have a request to members of Congress.
Not real per se.
Stimulus money. They want the federal government to bail out a project to expand the Washington State Convention Center in downtown.
But we can put chunks of bright yellow.
Say the economic fallout of the pandemic
could
cut
stop
construction in a year or less.
We could even do some of the vertical lines.
The team says the project is vital to helping the region's economy recover.
Giving the idea of that vertical motion.
Our regional economy is the visitor industry.
Now I got some really heavier.
The convention center expansion was billed as a project that would physically transform downtown Seattle and also boost economic activity. This is KNKX. Support for KNKX comes from
financial advisor Matthew McClellan of Edward Jones.
Okay, now I got it.
Second opinions on stock portfolios and other investment services at Edward Jones.
So now we're on to Mark Rothko. We're on to something that really does look like his work. That I can put away.
Support for NPR comes from NPR stations.
Put that away.
Include the Joyce Foundation. Committed to
close all. What he would normally do is have some geometric shapes. He would love to do squares or rectangles or bars of black that went over the space. So I'm going to look for really strong, full strength. Not going to dilute it.
50% chance of showers on Wednesday and showers very likely on Thursday with a chance of showers Friday.
I think I'm going to keep it right like this.
It's 6:06. This is 88.5 KNKX.
Now he also did
this is fresh air.
Little dry brush details. Black is so strong.
Today,
the pigment.
Remember comedian and actor Jerry Stiller, who died on Monday from natural causes. He was 92. Jerry Stiller had success as an actor on stage.
It's got just a little bit of the board shining.
Playing George Costanza's father on Seinfeld. He also played Divine's husband in the John Waters film Hairspray. Back in the Ed Sullivan era, he was known as half of the comedy team Stiller and Mira with his wife, Ann Mira. Their act played off what an improbable couple they made. He was short, schlumpy, Jewish. She was tall, attractive, Irish. Let's hear a sample from a live routine. 13 that came out on a record in 1967.
I love you, Mary Elizabeth Doyle.
Oh, I love you, Hershey Horowitz.
Will you marry me?
Yeah, I will. I will.
Never work.
What do you mean it'll never work?
It's impossible.
Of course it'll work.
My father's a Jewish banker, Becky. Your father's an Irish cop.
What difference?
Maybe what difference? It's like a hot pastrami on white bread.
Oh, come on.
We
love each other.
Love, Mom, it's a world of hate. Don't you understand?
Look, Hershey, it'll work out. The families will go crazy for each other.
Go crazy? That's what they'll do.
I'll grab your mother. I'll hug her. I'll kiss her. I'll say, Mrs. Horowitz, you're terrific. I hear you make the best mashugana ball soup in the world.
Lots of ball soup. Yes, 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 that's it. That's a new talent.
Yeah. Yeah. And I'll say, gee, you know where we're going? Your son and I are going to go to Israel on our honeymoon.
Good.
We're going to live on a Kanish for a couple of
weeks.
Right, so now what we've got, two planes divided by warms and cools, the illusion of horizon. Pretty cool. Welcome to Mark Rothko. Talk to you soon.